Humans are more closely related to fungi than any other kingdom. In fact, we share the same pathogens. It is because of this that our best antibiotics come from fungi. For thousands of years, fungi have been known to be both nutritious and immune-building. Now, modern research is beginning to validate traditional herbal beliefs about mushrooms. There are over 140,000 species of mushroom-forming fungi, of which about 100 are being studied for their health-promoting benefits. I'm Dr. Jeremy Wolf, and in this episode of Ask the ND, we're going to spend some time talking about some of the most commonly used medicinal mushrooms and their health-supporting benefits. Mushrooms are a unique group of organisms called fungi. Fungal colonies are composed of mycelium, a thread-like network that grows underground or in wood. This network allows fungi to absorb nutrients from their environment. Essentially, mushrooms are nature's recycling agents. Without them, plants would not have the nutrients to grow. Fungi are also able to absorb nutrients from plants, and the result of this process is the production of mushrooms. Mushrooms are packed with polysaccharides, beta-glucans, proteins, minerals, vitamins, and are low in fat and cholesterol. According to Hippocrates, the father of medicine, mushrooms can stimulate certain healing processes. Traditional Chinese medicine also mentions mushrooms belonging to the highest class of medicines, or tonics, and they can impart strength, vigor, and longevity. Let's take a closer look at some of the most commonly used mushrooms and their health benefits. Here's the rundown. Ganoderma lucidum, more commonly known as Reishi, is a mushroom that has been used throughout Asia for thousands of years. It's also known as the plant of immortality. Its long list of possible benefits include a nervous system tonic for anxiety, nervousness, and insomnia. It may also help age-related degenerative diseases such as Alzheimer's, coronary heart disease, and cancer. In fact, the Japanese government has officially listed reishi as an adjunct herb for cancer treatment. Lastly, it may also be beneficial for high blood pressure, liver diseases such as hepatitis B, and as an anti-inflammatory. Cordyceps sinensis, also commonly known as the caterpillar fungus, has many traditional benefits. Recent studies have found it to have promising effects on liver and kidney disease. It is also believed to be a very strong adaptogen used to fight fatigue, enhance endurance, and improve performance while also improving sexual potency and desire. Lastly, cordyceps may have strong anti-hyperglycemic activity, making it possibly beneficial for diabetes. Lentinula edodes, also known as shiitake, is a well-known mushroom because of its use in the culinary world. There are two types of shiitake preparations that have been studied, lentinin and an extract of the mycelium called LEM, or LEM. These mushrooms may be beneficial in almost any condition where the immune system requires a boost, such as allergies, infection, cancer due to its anti-tumor properties, and HIV. They may even help to reduce inflammation that the immune system produces. Lastly, shiitake mushrooms may also contain cholesterol-lowering abilities. When it comes to choosing a mushroom product, they are sold individually or as a preparation that contains a blend of different mushrooms. These supplements also come as liquid extracts or capsules. Neither is necessarily better than the other. Fungi absorb food and nutrients as well as potentially harmful substances such as pesticides, herbicides, and heavy metals from their surrounding environment. It's important to make sure your supplements are from organically grown sources. Lastly, as always, make sure to consult your healthcare provider before starting any supplements. Thank you for watching another edition of Ask the ND. Make sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel for weekly tips to help you on your journey towards happy wellness. From all of us here at Lucky Vitamin, spread the wellness.